4 years have passed since he left her. 4 years have passed since he swore he'd come back for her. But he didn't. And her? Well, she's still waiting for him. Holding on to that sliver of hope that he's coming back.
The sky is turning golden now. Wish you were with me now. My body aches for you. Feels empty since you've left. Is anybody left that isn't broken, shattered, confused?
I'm leaving for New York, Kyra.
Ain't no more on.
I'm sorry.
Don't.
I hate to leave you here, but...
You made a deal, remember? You'll pursue your dream of studying in New York, and I'll pursue my dream of going to law school.
4 years is a really long time to be away from you.
I know, but we'll make it work, like we always say. You have to promise me you didn't look at other girls. There are a lot of prettier, smarter girls there.
But they will never be you.
You have to promise me you'd come back after you graduate.
I promise.
Pinky swear?
Pinky swear.
Where are you, Ron? Hero. What are you doing here, Sydney? Looking for you! Why? What's wrong? Kyra, I should be the one asking you that. What's wrong with you? Nothing's wrong with me. What are you talking about? Kyra, it's been 4 years and 3 months, yet he never showed up. He's long been overdue. Wake up already! Ron's not coming back! Do you know why we agreed to meet here?
Why?
Because this is where we first met.
Mind if I sit here? So, what's a girl like you doing at a lonely place like this?
Trying to escape from the horror that is reality.
How?
By staring at an empty space.
Really?
It's pretty nice looking at nothing. How about you? What are you doing here?
Selling time pass.
And you chose the park as your venue?
That's the best thing I could think of. By the way, I'm Ron Castillo.
Kyra. Kyra, as much as I like to see the flashbacks of your love story, I can't bear to watch you destroy yourself.
How am I destroying myself?
You're basically waiting for someone who's not coming back. Ron has forgotten you. He has forgotten about you.
He's going to come back, Sydney. I can feel it.
working for 3 months now, but I'm not giving up, because I know that we'll see each other again soon.
According to your will, but watching you wait in vain for 4 years and 3 months is enough. One can only wait for so long.
Just give me one more day. If he doesn't arrive by tomorrow, I'd let go completely.
Fine, one more day. Promise?
Pinky swear.
Promise. Today's the day, Kyra. The day. Kyra! Kyra! Kyra, wake up! Kyra! Kyra, I have to take you to the hospital now! No, Kyra, he's not coming back! Kyra, wake up!
Ron's here. Ron's here.
What? Where? Kyra? Kyra?
The tears come streaming down your face.
Kyra, wake up! Ron's not here yet! You promised him, remember? Kyra! Kyra, don't leave me!
When you love someone, but it goes to waste. Could it be worse? Lights will guide. down below. Too in love to let it go. But if you never try, you'll never know just what you're worth. Lights will guide you home.
You're the reason why my best friend's gone. If you did not leave her with that stupid promise that you would return, she would still be here. It's all your fault.
Liar.
God.
You home and ignite your bones, and I will try to fix you.
Dear Sydney, by the time you're reading this letter, I'm probably gone.
I don't really know where to begin. But I guess I should begin with the words you deserve to hear. I'm sorry. I'm sorry because I left. The truth is, I was never suffering from asthma. I was suffering from cystic fibrosis. It's a genetic disease that has no treatment. I knew my days were counted, but I chose not to tell you because I didn't want you to worry about me. I'm sorry because I lied. The truth is, Ron's gone. On the day of his flight to New York, his plane crashed, ending his life. So, why did I hold on? Simple. Because I knew we'd meet again very soon. And I couldn't think of a better way to leave this world than by fulfilling our promise. The moment I physically left, I spiritually reunited with him at the spot we agreed on, the park. I'm sorry for keeping all these things from you, and thank you for being the best friend anyone could ever ask for. I may not be with you physically now, but I'll watch you from here, I promise.
Kyra.
Hey, I know you're here. Listen, I forgive you, Kyra. You never really had to apologize for anything. It all makes sense now, you know. Okay. It's leaving me near finding your happiness. I won't be selfish. Go pursue it.
But I have to breathe without you. But I have to.
it's not happy ever after. But guess what? There couldn't have been a better ending to the story of Kyra, the girl who believed.
I just wanna know, you better know, you better know, you better know.